Hey everyone, I'm Matty. In the last video, I showed you how to connect a Bluetooth low energy module to Arduino Nano microcontroller and how to communicate between the two of them. If you haven't watched the video, you can find it linked in the description below. In this video, I will show you how to connect an Android device to the Arduino Nano through the Bluetooth low energy module. I will just show you what you need to connect Android to the Arduino Nano through Bluetooth and also the steps I did to connect them. For more comprehensive tutorial, I wrote a blog. You can find the link for this blog in the description below. So let's start. First, try to create this UI. For this, we need one text view to show the information to the user and three buttons. Connect button, disconnect button, and button to switch the LED. Also, to use Bluetooth, we need some permissions. The first two permissions are self-explanatory, but you also need some find location permission. This permission is needed so you can search for other Bluetooth devices. Without this permission, you will not be able to find any devices. So, knowing this, let's now see what we need to connect to the Bluetooth. First, we have to make sure that the device supports Bluetooth. For this, I wrote this function, check BLE support. This function just checks if the device has Bluetooth, and if it doesn't, it shows a toast message and exits the app. The second thing we have to check is if we have the find location permission. I wrote this method for this. Here I just check if we have the permission, and if not, I ask the user to give the permission again. Then, in the onStart method, I check if the Bluetooth is enabled. If not, I ask the user to enable the Bluetooth. With this, we are ready to establish the connection. I put all Bluetooth code in BLE controller class. In the init method here, we start the scan for Bluetooth devices. This method requires a callback. When a Bluetooth device is found, I first check if this is the device we are looking for. In this method, I just checked if this device has the name we set in the previous tutorial, Blue Card. If the right device is found, we fire a device found event. In the main activity, when a device found event is received, I just enable the connect button. Now the user can connect to this device. Pressing the connect button calls the connect to device method in the BLE controller. This method calls connect GATT, which also need a callback. In the callback, when the connection is established, we need to find the right service to use. That's why we start discover services. When a service is discovered, we check if this is the right one. So, this service should have the UUID we set in the previous tutorial and the characteristic UUID we also set in the previous tutorial. When these conditions are met, then this is the right server for us and we have to save the characteristic for later use. With this, the connection is established. In the main activity, when a Bluetooth device is connected, we can enable the disconnect button and the switch LED button. Now, after we have connected to a Bluetooth device, we can send commands to the Arduino Nano. Before we do this, we have to decide how the commands will be sent to the Arduino Nano. For this, I created the Remote Controller class. Every command has a header. The header starts with a start byte, then it has the type of the command, then the length of the arguments, and following in that are the arguments. This is a little bit overkill for turning on and off an LED, but we will need this in the next tutorials when we send different commands for controlling the DC motor and the servo motor. To send data to the Bluetooth module, I implemented the sendData method in the BLE controller class. This method uses the saved characteristic that we saved on device connected and sends the data. The switchLED method just gets a boolean to turn it on and off and send LED command with one variable which is on or off. So now in the switch LED button we can just call the switch LED method and give it a boolean variable to turn it on or off. This is all from the Android side. Now let's see the Arduino side. Arduino sketch, I created a new file called controller. In this file I defined a function named execute command. These functions become a command array directly from Android. In this case we have only one command, switch led. When switch led command is sent, we just code switch light and give the value to turn the LED on and off. Now, in the Bluetooth file, we don't need update serial anymore, but instead we use read command. Read command just reads the whole array until all parameters are read and calls execute command. All is left now is to call in loop read command instead of update serial. And that's it. Now let's see how it's working. If you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching.